Hello my dear friends, students. This is my third video lecture. In first video, we will discuss the brief idea as concerns the new syllabus of the 12th standard biology. In my second video, we will study the very important topic as concerns the exam, that is reproduction. First we discuss what is meant by reproduction. Then we discuss some salient feature as concerns the reproduction. Then we discuss the modes of reproduction. Then we discuss the second mode of reproduction, that is sexual reproduction. As concerns the sexual reproduction, the site, that is flower. Hence we will briefly discuss the exact structure of flower. As concerns the flower, first we define what is meant by exact flower. The flower is nothing but it is highly modified and condensed shoot. This specially designed for the sexual reproduction. Now when we discuss the typical flower having the four different whorls. Now the first whorl, that is calyx, the second whorl, that is corolla, third whorl, that is androecium, and fourth whorl, that is gynoecium. Now the first two whorls, that is calyx and corolla, these two whorls are not directly participate in the sexual reproduction. The remaining two whorls, that is androecium, which is also called as male reproductive whorl, and the gynoecium, which is also called as the female reproductive whorl. These two whorls are directly participated in the sexual reproduction. Hence, first we discuss what is meant by androecium, the individual member of the androecium, that is stamen, the brief structure of stamen. Then we discuss the structure of anther, that is TS of anther. Then we discuss the microsporogenesis. Then we discuss the exact what is meant by the structure of the microspore of the pollen grain. And lastly, we conclude the second video with the help of the exact development of male gametophyte. Now, in this lecture, we have to discuss the remaining part as concerns the sexual reproduction, that is the development of female gametophyte. We have to discuss the exact development of female gametophyte. First, we have to discuss the introductory part as concerns the entire structure of the female gametophyte. Okay. Now, see here, the gynoecium, it acts as a female reproductive whorl. The gynoecium, it is said to be female reproductive whorl. The individual member of gynoecium, it is called carpel. The individual member of gynoecium, it is called carpel, which is also called as megasporophyll. What it is also called as megasporophyll. When we deeply observe all the members of carpel within the flower, when these carpels are free, the condition, it is said to be apocarpous. Apo means free. When the carpels or the megasporophyll within the flower, these are in free condition, then it is said to be apocarpous condition. One example, that is mycelia. Now when these carpels, these megasporophyll, these are fused, these are united, then the condition, it is said to be syncarpous. Syn means fused, syn means united. Hence the condition, it is said to be syncarpal. One example, that is brinjal. When we observe the exact typical structure of the carpel, again the carpel having the three different parts. Now the first part of carpel, it is said to be stigma. The second part of carpel, it is said to be style. And the next, last and very important part of the carpel, it is said to be ori. In this way, the stigma, style, ori come together, it gives rise to the specific structure of the flower. That specific structure, it is said to be carpel, which is called as the individual member of the female reproductive whorl, that is gynoecium. Got it? Now we discuss the next part, the structure of anatropous ovule. We have to discuss the structure of anatropous ovule. Now see here, the picture of the anatropous ovule, here it is. Now, first we discuss the exact thing as concerns the structure of anatropous ovule. When the stalk, that is funicle, and the micropyle come adjacent, come parallel to each other, now that specific ovule, it is said to be anatropous ovule. Now we discuss one by one each part of the ovule. Now the first part, that is basal part, it is said to be chalaza. Now the basal part, it is said to be chalaza. Now the apical portion or the apical core, it is said to be micropyle. Apical core, it is said to be micropyle. Now the parenchymatous tissue, it forms the very important structure, that is mucilus. The next part as concerns the anatropous ovule, the parenchymatous tissue, it forms the mucilus. Now the stalk of the ovule, which is attached with the placenta, that is fertile tissue, it is said to be funicle. Now the ovule, when it is attached to the placenta, that attachment point it is said to be hilum. Attachment point it is said to be hilum. Now after the successful development of the female gametophyte, finally it gives rise to the embryo sac of the female gametophyte. Okay, we have to discuss how it is formed. Now here it is picture of the structure of N.R.Chopade ovule. Now as concerned the N.R.Chopade ovule, the important things are, first that is chalaza, second one that is micropyle, third one that is nucellus, next integuments, that is these are the protective coverings, micropyle and chalaza collectively it form the PS of N.R.Chopade ovule. Now see here again the structure of N.R.Chopade ovule. Here there is a attachment point which is called as the placenta. Here it is stalk of the ovule which is called as a funicle. Now this is the all things as concerned the ovule. When it is attached to placenta, that attachment point it is said to be hilum. Now these are the protective coverings which is called as the integuments. Here at the outer side, here it acts as the outer integument. Here at the inner side, it acts as a inner integument. Now this is the central portion which is called as the exact female gametophyte, which is called as the exact embryo sac. We have to discuss how it is formed. Okay, now this is specific pore, it is said to be micropyle, and that specific portion it is said to be basal chalaza. Okay, now we have to discuss the next thing as concerned the development of female gametophyte. Very important thing, that is megasporogenesis. Remember megasporogenesis. See here the definition of megasporogenesis: the formation of haploid megaspore. The formation of haploid megaspore from the diploid megaspore mother cell. From the diploid megaspore mother cell, the process through the meiosis, the process it is said to be megasporogenesis. It is very very important process as concerned the development of embryo sac or the female gametophyte. Once again I repeat the same thing: the formation of haploid megaspores. The formation of haploid megaspore from the diploid megaspore mother cell through the meiosis, the process it is said to be megasporogenesis. Now we have to discuss how the exact development of female gametophyte takes place. Now see here what happens. There are different steps, different things as concerned the development of female gametophyte. Now the first thing here, the diploid megaspore mother cell undergoes meiosis to form the linear tetrad of haploid cells, which is also called as the megaspore. This is the first step or the first event. Now from that four haploid megaspore, the upper three abort, upper three degenerated, and the lowest one, that is one remain, it is only functional. Now that functional megaspore, it undergoes three successive pre-nuclear mitotic reunions. Very very important step. This functional megaspore undergoes three successive pre-nuclear mitotic divisions. Thus, it leads to formation of eight nuclei, four at each pole. Now, the one nuclei from each pole migrate towards the center. From that four, the one nuclei from each pole migrate towards the center, fuse to form diploid secondary, or it is also called as definitive nucleus. It is also called as definitive nucleus. Now the three remaining, the three nuclei towards the micropyle end consist center large haploid egg cell and the two supporting haploid synergid cells. Now next part, at the chalazal end, the three haploid cells called antipodals. Thus, in this way, the seven cell with eight nucleate structure. In this way, the seven cell with eight nucleate structure in a nucellus is called female gametophyte, or it is also called as embryo sac. It is also called as embryo sac. Now the characteristics of female gametophyte or the embryo sac, it is endosporic and it is monosporic. Endosporic, endo means inside. Within the spore, it is takes place, the characteristic is endosporic, and the monosporic, mono means one, mono means single. The entire embryo sac, the entire female gametophyte, it is developed with the help of single megaspore, and the characteristics monosporic, endosporic and monosporic development. Now we have to see again that entire thing with the help of picture. See here,
Here there is a
megaspore mother cell which is in diploid condition. Here there is a megaspore mother cell in diploid condition. That megaspore mother cell which is in diploid condition, it undergo meiosis. After the successful meiosis, it give rise to the 4 haploid megaspores. It give rise to the 4 haploid megaspores. From that 4 haploid megaspore, the upper 3 megaspores, these are degenerated. These are degenerated. And the lower one, it becomes functional. These single, only functional. It acts as a first initial cell as concerns the development of embryo sac or the female gametophyte. Okay? Now that this single functional megaspore undergo 3 free mitotic nuclear cell divisions. Now here it is first mitosis, here it is second mitosis, and here it is third mitosis. After the first, second and third mitosis, it totally give rise to the 8 nuclei. It give rise to the 8 nuclei. Again, when there is a, after the end of third mitosis, there is a reshuffling of a nuclei, this takes place. From these 4 nuclei, one comes at this region, that is center. From the lower side, again it comes at the center. At this end, only the 3 antipodal cell structure forms with the help of 3 cells. Here there is a 3 cells, it gives the 2 synergids and 1 female gamete or the 1 egg cell, and at the center the 2 polar nuclei come together, finally it gives rise to 1 single cell. In this way, with the help of single functional megaspore, at the end of all events, finally it gives rise to the female gametophyte or the embryo sac, it is also called as. Again, the mature embryo sac, it is called as female gametophyte. Just before fertilization, it is in the 7 nuclei present and 6 are haploid, one is diploid. At the center, the diploid nuclei present. In this way, this is the entire idea as concerns the development of female gametophyte. Thank you.